Hello students, welcome back. Today I'm Anuradha from Arden Progressive School, going to start another topic of the same chapter, that is human reproduction. Okay, so in this chapter already we have covered about the male reproductive system. Okay, so today we are going to start with the female reproductive system. Why is it so? Because we know that in case of human beings, what type of reproduction will be there? Sexual reproduction. And for the need of sexual reproduction, there must be gametes, and there must be two different type of gamete, that is the male gamete as well as the female gamete. And what is the male gamete? It is the sperm. And what is the female gamete? It is an ovum. So how they will produce? Okay, so to produce or for to formation of this gamete, there is a process which is known as the gametogenesis. Okay, when there will be gametogenesis, then only what will happen? There will be fertilization. Okay, so we can say that like this, that it's a pre-fertilization events, as we have done in case of the flowering plants. Okay, so here what we are going to study about the structure or the gamete, how it will form in case of male. So for that we have done about the male reproductive system, how there will be formation. We will study that, and as well as we have already covered that what are the different parts which is present in the male reproductive system. Okay, so likewise today we are going to start with what are the different parts of the female reproductive system. Okay, system means that there are some thing or there are some components which they are coordinating with each other. Okay, then only there will be formation of female gamete, right? So here what are the different parts? A pair of ovaries. Pair means two ovaries will be there, and then pair of oviduct. What is oviduct? It is nothing. It is also known as fallopian tube. Okay, it is what? So if we are having two ovaries, so for that we are having two fallopian tube. Okay, so it's also in a paired form. Then comes to the uterus, then the third cervix, vagina, as well as the external genitalia, as we have done in case of male reproductive system also. Okay, and the last one is the mammary gland, because they are also associated with the reproduction, right? So if I will talk about the division, we know that we are having two types. What are they? Primary characters as well as secondary one. Okay, primary sexual characteristics and the secondary sexual characteristics. So here if I will talk about the ovaries, they are the primary character. Okay, what it is? It is a primary sexual organ. Why it is so? Because it is giving rise to the female gamete, same like we have done in case of male also. Their testis was the that primary characteristics, right? So here what we will term here, the ovaries, because they are going to form the ovum or the egg, right? Here, and these parts, what are they? These are the accessory organs, or we can say accessory ducts, as we have done in case of the male reproductive system also, right? So what is going to happen? Ovaries, uterus, cervix, vagina, so all these will compose what? It will form the accessory one, right? As well as at the last, from where we are having some external genitalia also, right? So one by one we will understand that how these are formed, or what is the function of each and every component, right? Here I have shown one diagram. This is of what? This is a female reproductive system. And again, this diagram becomes very, very important, because it is showing each and every part of the female, right? Here, so let's start with the first one, that is the ovary. Okay, so this is the pair of ovary, and these ovaries, they are connected to what? These are connected to some to this uterus region as well as the pelvic region. Okay, because whatever we are talking about the reproductive system, they are situated where? Into the pelvic region. So where it is connected, all these ovaries, they are having the ovarian ligament, right, which is connecting the ovary with the this uterus part, right? Here, and from here the second one is the oviduct, and these fallopian tube, these tube like structure are what? These are the oviduct, or we can say fallopian tube. And this triangular part, okay, it is known as the uterus. And the fourth one, that is the cervix, this is the opening, right? Here, this is the opening, which is known as cervix. And again after that there will be the anterior opening, which we will call the vagina. Okay, so one by one we will understand from here. So let's start with the first one, that is the ovaries. Okay, what is the function of ovary? It means that it will form the ovum. Okay, whatever the form, later on we will understand that what is the menstrual cycle, what are the cyclic changes, okay, what is the different phases it is going to happen. But here we have to understand what is the function of ovary, that it is forming an ovum. So whatever ovum it will form, it will move towards where? It will move towards this fallopian tube. Why it is so? Because here when it will travel, what will happen? The sperm which is going to come from this urogenital tract, it will get fused with this one. Okay, so what is going to happen? The first part is that one on each side of lower abdomen. So where you can see this ovary here in the lower abdomen, and it is situating at the both side, this side also as well as this side, right? Then if I will talk about the length, okay, so the length is what? It is 2 to 4 centimeter in length and connected to the pelvic wall. As I have said that it is connecting to some backward part also. Okay, so how it is connected with the pelvic wall as well as the uterus. Okay, so what are these things which are responsible for this connection? These are known as the ligaments, and here it is present in the ovary, so we are calling it ovarian ligament. Right, then comes to the another point, that ovary is connected or it is surrounded by some epithelium there. Okay, now what do you understand? If I will show you the simpler diagram of this ovary, okay, if this is the ovary, right, and what we are saying that this ovary is covered by some epithelium, it means that some cuboidal epithelial cells are present here like this. Okay, so this is surrounded like the whole ovary, right? So this is what? This is the epithelium, right, which is having the germinal layer, and after that inside it it is having some stroma. What it is having? It is having stroma. So if I will draw the structure like this, okay, so the whole part which is present inside the ovary, what you are calling it, this is known as the stroma, and this stroma is divided into two zones. Okay, so whole which is present inside the ovary, what we have called it? The stroma. And stroma having two zones. What are they? The peripheral zone. Peripheral means that zone which is covered by the peripheral region, okay, at the peripheral end, and the another one is the medullary region. Okay, so outer one is what? This is the peripheral region. So this whole part, what you will call it? It is known as the cortex, right? And this inner part, what we will call it? It is known as the medulla. Okay, so this ovary is present internally like this, right here. So now what is going to happen inside this ovary? Every month, okay, there will be formation of so many follicles. Okay, so one by one we will understand in the later session what is going to happen. It will form the different follicles, and all the follicles will not going to mature. Okay, what will happen? They will get degenerated, and one of the follicle will get rupture, and due to the rupturation of this follicle, what will happen? This egg will release, and this released egg will be taken up by the fimbriae. Okay, what is going to happen? Whatever the ovum or the egg released by this ovary, it will be taken by the fallopian tube. And how the fallopian tube it will take? With the help of these finger like fimbriae. Okay, so you can see the structure. So what is it is going to do? It will just move like this, okay, and just it will engulf it, right, like this. So second part, what we are studying? Oviduct or the fallopian tube. Why? Because again, very important role of this fallopian tube, and this fallopian tube having different parts. From here to here we are calling it fallopian tube. So the part which is present here, which you can see here, it is in conical shape. Okay, the part which is in conical shape, what you will call it? You will call it infundibulum. Okay, infundibulum is a conical structure which is present here nearer to this part, okay, near to this ovary. Now another part of this fallopian tube, it is known as the fimbriae. Fimbriae is what? These are the projections which is present in this triangular or the conical structure which we have called infundibulum. This is what? This is the fimbriae. Okay, and afterward what will happen when the egg will will reach here, it will move like this. Okay, how it will move? It will move like this in this fallopian tube, and where it will reach? It will reach into the ampullar region. What is the ampullar region? It is the swollen structure. Okay, the swollen structure which is present in this fallopian tube, what we are calling it? We are calling it ampulla. Ampulla means something which is swollen in structure. Okay, afterwards what will happen? That there will be a narrower part. You can see it here, that here in ampulla region the tube is having some larger structure, or it is wider one, and as it is moving forward it will become narrower one. So what you will call this structure? You will call it isthmus. Okay, so another part is what? It is known as the isthmus. So these are the different part of the fallopian tube. So what is happening in this ampullar isthmic region? If I will ask the specific line that at which part of the fallopian tube fertilization will take place, you will answer that what it is region? Ampullar isthmic region. Okay, initially in the lower grades we know that fertilization takes place where? Into the fallopian tube. But here we will give a specific answer that this swollen structure, what will happen? As the egg will reach here, and from here if sperm will come here, okay, so what will happen? There will be fertilization. Okay, and due to this fertilization there will be formation of zygote. So here what we have understood, that as the ovary will release ovum, it would be taken by the femurae and it will move forward to the infundibulum, and then after it will reach to the ampullar region. From the ampullar region it will move further, which is known as the isthmic region. So this question can be asked as a pathway. Okay, so you should know and you have to memorize what is the sequential pathway, right? In that way only you have to memorize it. Now we have done the two parts of the female reproductive system. Now what will happen? We will reach towards the uterus. Okay, so now what will happen? Once the fertilization has been completed here, the zygote, it will move forward and it will reach where? It will reach into this wall. Okay, where it will reach? It will reach into this wall, and this wall is what? It is the uterine wall. What you will call this term? Uterine wall. Okay, and now here you can see this whole part which is known as the uterus. In your NCERT it is given that what is the shape of the uterus? It is just like inverted pear. You must have seen the pear. Okay, so here you can imagine that, you can compare the pear, but pear is somehow inverted. So the structure of uterus is what? It is an inverted one, and again this is having three different layers. Okay, uterus having three different layers. So outermost layer which you can see here from the blue marker. Okay, and it is situated at the peripheral region. Okay, towards the outer part. What you will call it? You will call it perimetrium. Okay, peri means to the peripheral end, and then inner to it, this part, this whole part which you can see it here, this is what? This is known as the myometrium. What you will call it? You will call it myometrium. Why it is so? Because it is present in the between. Okay, and inner to it, the innermost layer which I have drawn with the red marker, it is known as what? It is known as the endometrium. And the role of endometrium is very very important. And what is endometrium? It is the thin inner lining of the uterus. Okay, where this one will get attached. Okay, so directly it will not get attached, there will be some more division. Okay, from reaching from this part to this part, it will undergo several cleavage. Okay, so we will understand in the next step as you will study about the after completing the gametogenesis. Okay, now right now what you have to understand? Only the structure. So what is going to happen? That this uterus having three linings. What are they? Perimetrium, myometrium and the endometrium. And what is the role of each layer? We have to understand. See here, the outer perimetrium layer, it is for the protection. Okay, and this myometrium which is present here, it is made up of smooth cells. Okay, so what it is happening during the expelling out of the baby, okay, when the baby has to expel out or during the delivery time, the muscles should contract or relax, okay. So what is happening, it is contracting and relaxing, and due to that, what is happening, there will be a easy delivering of the baby, right here. So what is the function of the myometrium during the delivery time, right? Now comes to the function of this endometrium. This endometrium layer is having a very thickness. Why it is so? Because it can change every time. So during the menstrual phase or during the menstrual cycle, what is happening? This lining will get changed. Okay, and what is that role? That during that particular phase, when the body will get the ovum here. Okay, so at the same time, during the time when this egg is going into this fallopian tube, at the same time there will be formation of this endometrium wall. Why it is so? Because we know that in case of flowering plants, we have done that first there will be formation of endosperm. Okay, it means that firstly there will be preparation for the nutrition, then after there will be formation of zygote. Same here, what is happening, that as it is entering into the fallopian tube for the fertilization, so on that time, on the same time, it will form this lining also. Okay, and due to this thickness of this lining, what will happen, it contains blood vessels, so it is preparing the uterus after the fertilization. Okay, it is preparing the uterus for after the fertilization, so that if the structure, if embryo will attached here, it can be get proper nutrition from here. Okay, because with the help of placenta it will get attached here. So how it will get nutrition? During the time when it is collecting the blood here. Okay, if there will be fertilization, what will happen, it can implant easily here. But if there will be no fertilization, if there will be no entry of sperms, what will happen, then this wall will get ruptured out, or this wall get broke down. Okay, and this is the bleeding phase of the menstrual cycle, in which what will happen, if there will be no entry of, if there will be no fertilization, this inner lining will get disturbed and as a bleeding, right here. So we will understand all these things later on. Initially, what we have to do, that what are the three different layers of the uterus and what are the different function of these layers, right here. So we have completed here also up to the uterus, right? Then comes to the cervix. Cervix is what? It is the ending portion. Okay, it is the pore. You can see it here, there will be two openings, okay, external orifice and internal orifice. Make sure that whenever I'm using the word orifice, orifice means what? Opening. Okay, in scientific language we are using the term orifice. So what is happening, this is the internal one and this is the external orifice, right? And when this part, it is known as what? This is known as the cervix, or the ending point of the uterus. And don't confuse between cervix and vagina. Okay, after the cervix there will be one more opening which is known as the vagina. Okay, and when we are including both the thing, this is what? This is the cervical canal. Okay, and this is the vaginal canal, right? So when both they are forming, what they are making? They are making the birth canal. Okay, and due to this birth canal, what is happening? The baby will get expelled out. So birth canal is what? It is a combination of both cervical canal as well as the vaginal canal. And upper to this vaginal canal, okay, or vagina, there will be thin layer which is known as what? Hymen. Okay, this one is very, very important, because during the older times, people used to think that it is showing only and only the virginity, but it doesn't like this. Why it is so? Because during the heavy exercise, horse riding, cycling, what happens? Usually it becomes degraded, okay, and that's why the semen is what? This is a covering. Right, and sometimes it happens that during the first coitus it will get also disturbed, okay, and due to that there will be some a little bleeding, right? So what uterus is, the in like a inverted pear shape, and it attached to the pelvic wall. Three layers are there: perimetrium, myometrium and endometrium. We have completed. Then comes to cervix having the opening which is known as the cervical canal. Then comes to the vagina also having the vaginal canal, which is having 8.5 centimeter length. Okay, now comes to the sixth one, that is the external genitalia. Okay, or means the outer part. So in this outer part, we are having again these different parts. What are they? Mons pubis, labia majora, labia minora, hymen, as well as the clitoris. Okay, what do you understand? If I will show you the structure of the female part or the female reproductive, so what we are having, that the mons pubis, what it is the pubis hair, okay, the hair which is present in the outer part, as well as it consists of the fatty layer also. So what is this mons pubis? This is the fatty part as well as the hair part which is present in the outer part, as well as if you will see internally, what you can say, that two lips like structures are present. Okay, what is the meaning of this labia? Labia means lips like structure. Okay, so we are having the outer one is what? It is the outer lips, what you will call it, labia majora, and the inner one, it is known as the labia minora. Okay, and here again there will be some openings which is present internally in the vaginal part. Okay, you can see all these things in the vaginal part. What is there? There will be two openings. If I will talk about the male reproductive system, there will be only one opening, okay, for the releasing of sperm as well as for the urination. But here there will be two pores or two openings which we are calling orifice. First one is what? Urethral orifice for the urination, and another one is the vaginal orifice for the vagina part. Right here and here again there will be small glands are present, which is known as the Bartholin's gland. This one is very important. Why? During the coitus, what is happening? They are providing lubrication. Okay, some of the lubrication provided by what? By this Bartholin's gland, and due to this there will be easy entry of the penis. Right here, then comes to the majora, we have completed minora, then comes to the hymen. As we have said, the hymen is what? It is a covering which is present above to what? Above to the vagina, right? And here clitoris is what? It will act like a penis. In case of male reproductive system, what is the erection part? Because erection of penis is very, very important for the entry into the female urogenital tract. Okay, so here there is again important of clitoris. Why? Because it will act as the erectile portion for the female. Okay, so what is happening? We can say that clitoris having somehow the function related to the penis, and it is the erection part for the female. Okay, and we know that lower part of the body, it is ending with the anus. So here we have completed that what are the parts which is related to the female reproductive system, and these are what? These are the external genitalia, right? Now we have included the mammary glands also. Why? Because after the sexual reproduction, when there will be delivering of baby, what is happening? It needs some nutrition. So from where it will come? It will come from the milk secreted by the mother. Okay, so how it is helping here? So mammary glands are what? Because it is having the capacity to eject the milk here. And here if you will see the diagram of the mammary glands, internally it is having different parts. Okay, how they are helping here, what we have to understand, that what is the pathway, as we have done in case of male reproductive system also, female reproductive system also, here also we are having the part. So what are the part we are going to follow here? Glandular tissue or the fat. So in this mammary gland, most of the part it is covered by what? By the fat layer as well as the glandular tissue. And here the upper part, this apical part, which is known as the nipple, and around the nipple it is having some pigmented structure. Okay, so around this nipple it is having some pigmented structure, in which it is having, if I will draw the structure like this, okay, so around this nipple there will be some pigmented part, and it contains what? It contains some gland, and this gland is known as the sebaceous gland. Okay, and this pigmented area, what you are calling it? Areola. Okay, in this areolar part, what is happening? In this areolar part there will be some glands which is known as the sebaceous gland, as well as they are calling it areolar gland. Okay, it's just like the sweating gland, and here they are secreting some milk. Okay, so here we can say, if I will show you the internal structure of the mammary gland, so what is happening? It is happening having a 15 to 20 mammary lobes. So here you can see that what are these things? These are the mammary lobes. okay. So how many lobes can be there in one mammary gland or in one breast? It is the 15 to 20 lobes. So here in this lobe, okay, some clusters are present. In each lobe, some clusters are present. So I have written here, in each lobe, there are number of clusters. And what are these clusters? They are responsible for secreting the milk. Okay, they are responsible for secreting the milk, and what we are calling it, we are calling it alveoli. Okay, from here what is going to happen? It will get branched from here. Okay, as we have done in case of respiratory system also, what they are having? They are having bronchi. Okay, and at the end of bronchi, okay, bronchi, bronchiole, they are having some alveoli, or the alveoli sac. Okay, so same you can imagine here also. What are these? These are the alveoli which is present here in these mammary lobes. Okay, in this mammary lobes, what is happening? They will again move into some tube-like structure. Okay, so what it will do? It will move into some tube-like structure. What you are calling it? You are calling it the mammary tubules. Okay, the tubules or the tube which is present in the mammary, what we are calling it? Mammary tubules. Okay, from here this mammary tubules, it will move into the mammary ducts. What are these mammary ducts? This is the mammary duct. So here what is happening? That from these tubules, it will move here into this mammary duct. And duct is what? Something which is carrying the thing. Okay, in case of other body parts, we are having different duct system. Okay, so here this duct is present in the mammary gland. So what they are passing the things, okay, or they are passing the milk. So what are they? These are the mammary ducts. So from where I have started? From the mammary lobes, it is the first part. And from this mammary lobes, what is happening? It is moving into this mammary duct. Then where it will reach? It will reach into the mammary ampulla. And what I have said right now, ampulla is what? It is a swollen structure. Okay, so same here also, it is a swollen structure. So from the mammary duct, it will move towards the mammary ampulla. Now all the lobes, they are having the mammary lobe, ampulla, and all these are connected at one place. Okay, this is the common place where all these tubules are connected. Okay, so where these all tubules are connected and secreting at same place, what you will call it? Lactiferous duct. Okay, here we are talking about what? About the milk. And we know that lactogen, and that is what? It is a type of sugar which is present in the milk. Okay, so what is happening? That whatever the tubules, they are connected at one place, it will secrete or it will collect all the milk here. And what is that name of the duct? Lactiferous duct. So you have to understand the sequence. Mammary lobes, okay, these are the mammary lobes, and after the mammary lobes, it is moving into the tubules. And in tubules, the first part is what? Ducts are present. From the duct, it is moving towards the ampulla. From the ampulla, from all these tubules, they are connected at same place, which is known as the lactiferous duct. And in this duct, there will be accumulation of all the milk. And from this lactiferous duct, what is happening? It is moving out the milk through the nipples. Okay, and baby can suck it very easily. Okay, and this is very, very important role for every individual which is going to take birth. Okay, so we have to understand whole about it. So here we have completed both the male as well as female reproductive system. Now we will understand that how the gamete will form in case of male and how the gamete will form in case of female. In the definition, gametogenesis. So we will understand male gametogenesis as well as the female gametogenesis in the other class. Okay, so that's all for today. Thank you.